सर SI 3 रेस्पॉन्डिंग सर, दिस इज रामजी सर. आउट ऑफ 5 मेंबर्स 4 मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट सर, 1 CL सर.
द डे स्टार्ट्स अर्ली फॉर द सैनिटेशन वर्कर्स एंड ऑफिसर्स इन काकीनाडा, अ कोस्टल टाउन इन आंध्र प्रदेश. दे हैव अ लॉन्ग डे एट वर्क. काकीनाडा ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम अ सिटी with a daily household waste collection of a mere 38% to 100%. 60% of its residents now segregate their waste at the source, which was unheard of before. But how did Kakinada transform into a smart and clean city? Let us find out in this episode of The Cleanest Cities of India. Kakinada is situated on the coast of the Bay of Bengal. It is one of the three smart cities of Andhra Pradesh under the Smart Cities Mission. Before June 2020, every street in the city looked like a garbage dump yard. Municipal staff collected garbage irregularly, and 90% of the daily complaints reviewed by the municipality were related to municipal solid waste. Community bins used to overflow and attract stray animals. The corporation was understaffed, and clearing those bins on a daily basis was impossible.
Sanitation is not like other sections, because if one day if there is a sanitation less, which is very clearly visible, if you do sanitation hold 30 days in a month, you won't be finding any difference. But if you didn't do the sanitation didn't go well for one day, the sanitation labs will be clearly visible. For 1.5 years, I think there is no segregation in the CLB, because we didn't bring any awareness in the public at that time. Even our sanitation workers don't know that we have to collect it in wet waste and dry waste.
But it took about a year for the Kakinada Municipal Corporation, or the KMC, to evolve an efficient mechanism for the collection and processing of solid waste. After a series of deliberations, KMC decided that the best way to clean the city was by using modern surveillance and monitoring technologies.
After me being here, we are specifically focusing on sanitation as a major aspect, and also including the sanitation as a policy matter in each and every decision that we are taking from the corporation and also in the smart city. Other than that, the next policy decision or the change which we have taken is intensively monitoring the manpower and intensively monitoring the machines, the vehicles, and also using the IT for, that is, the digitalization of the entire sanitation as an aspect was done.
The KMC prepared a comprehensive sanitation plan for the city. The plan focused on monitoring of waste management systems using the latest technologies. The concept of integrated solid waste management was introduced to ensure end-to-end management of municipal solid waste, with a very heavy focus on increasing awareness using information, education, and communication campaigns in the entire city. In order to ensure efficient collection, timely transportation, and optimum processing, the city introduced the following technologies: facial recognition system, or FRS. Kakinada implemented FRS to register the attendance of its workers. Every day at 5 a.m., attendance of all sanitation workers is taken in their respective circles. FRS confirms the identity of workers by mapping their facial features and comparing the information with a database of known faces to find a match. This is to ensure that they reach their respective reporting locations on time to collect household waste. Implementation of FRS technology by Kakinada made attendance monitoring much easier through a centralized real-time monitoring system. Human Resource Management System, or HRMS mobile app. The city also introduced the HRMS app for its day-to-day waste management operations. HRMS helps the authorities to identify and trace each worker in each micro pocket of every ward in the city. The app has made it possible to ensure 100% presence of sanitary workers on the ground. Whenever a worker is absent due to any reason, the app makes it simple to replace them and get the work done with no hiccups. This system basically automates HR tasks and helps save money and time, as the authorities no longer have to manually keep track of every worker.
We have developed an app. In that app, once I go to an area and take the location, I will automatically come to know who are the workers who are responsible for the cleaning of that area. So it would help not only the corporation employees but also the public. Once public also comes to know about the information, they would naturally start asking for accountability from these workers also. So it is also being transparent towards the public, as well as it will help the corporation employees, the supervisory officers, basically to check whether the workers are working correctly or not. And in turn, we are having a foolproof manpower deployment plan as well as a vehicle deployment plan.
Once the workers are ready and equipped, they start the day by sweeping the public places like roads, lanes, parks, markets. The household waste collection starts after that, and here also the tech innovations are at the forefront. Global Positioning System, or GPS. KMC fitted every waste collection vehicle with a GPS device. They track the vehicles to ensure that they are traveling through the intended route. It also ensures that vehicles collect waste from the source at the right time and transport it to the destination in a timely manner. With the use of the GPS, KMC makes sure that the travel time of every vehicle is consistent with the distance it is meant to cover.
In this short run, we could also save nearly 80 lakhs of oil bills on our vehicles by just introducing the system of GPS tracking of the vehicles. We were tracking the vehicles, we were calculating the average distance which is being plied by all the vehicles, and accordingly the petrol or the diesel bills were cleared.
Radio frequency identification, or RFID tags. Each household has been given a sticker with a unique QR code, or quick response code. Waste collectors are equipped with QR code scanners and mandated to scan the code upon collection of waste at the doorstep. The handheld device is used to send the details of the household with its location, date and time of collection to the centralized command center at the office of the city corporation. The software connected to the RFID system compiles the data in real time, which is presented in a dashboard showing the number of sources covered at a given point. All these technologies implemented in Kakinada are connected to the Integrated Command and Communication Center. This is a centralized facility where a team of trained professionals keep an eye on big monitors to ensure waste management operations proceed as planned. KMC also realized that technology alone could not address the challenges of waste management. Participation from citizens is also important for building a clean city. KMC started a comprehensive campaign across the city to sensitize citizens on the need for source segregation. The campaign also addressed the need to stop littering while making people aware of various elements of waste processing. As of now, Kakinada City has managed to achieve a processing rate of 84% of the collected segregated waste. it also earned 45.76 lakh rupees as revenue from waste processing, which is 26% of its total expenditure. The city is processing 72 tons of biodegradable waste per day in two waste-to-compost plants that produce 18.7 tons per day of quality compost. The compost is packed and sold in the open market under the name of Nutri Manure. The city is channelizing 35.3 tons per day of non-biodegradable waste to various recycling facilities every day. Complaints about solid waste management in the city have reduced substantially over the past year. From 591 in June 2020 to 17 in August 2021.
Beginning, the people, they blamed us for collecting segregated waste. Why we are torturing them? They felt like it's a torture, segregating the waste. But once we explained them about what we are doing with that segregated waste, they too came forward. We are able to segregate nearly 60% in last 1 year. So it is, I think this is the maximum by any ULB in Andhra Pradesh, because collecting 60% is a, to us it's a huge success.
This huge success for a small city is a shining example of the potential of good governance and sanitation policies for the entire country.